If you're an indie game designer, chances are you have to wear lots of hats, just like me. On top of writing and coding, we generally have to dive into level design, posting online, and all sorts of stuff. That's why today, I'm sharing 12 tools that I use on a daily basis to speed up my work. Let's get started. Number 1. Shoebox. Shoebox is what its name suggests. It's a shoebox full of wonderful tools. It extracts sprites, generates sprite atlases, bitmap fonts, and does much more. Cherry on the cake, Shoebox's UI is slick and very easy to use. It all works with drag and drop. Please note that you need to have the Air runtime installed to run that application. Number 2. Caseum. Caseum is a fast, open source image compression software. I've tried out a few in the past, and Caseum really shined for its efficiency. With this software, you can quickly optimize both your JPEG and PNG files for your website or your games build. I used it to compress my bank of reference images from 12GB down to about 3.5GB. It's Windows only. Number 3. Bulk Rename Utility. Another free gem. Bulk Rename Utility is a batch renaming tool. Its interface may look a bit daunting at first, but it offers a lot of flexibility. Whether you need to add an index to your file's name, rename pictures using the metadata, or pretty much anything you could think of, this software does the job. It also gives you a preview of the names it will generate in real time. Once again, it's a Windows-only software. Number 4. Tilemap Editor. Tile is simply the best free tilemap editor available out there. Once again, it's an easy-to-use piece of software with a clean interface. It offers a solid auto-tile feature and tools to quickly generate and add variations to your levels. Not only that, but with Tiled, you can generate data such as shapes and variables to later use in your game engine as interactive elements. It's available on Windows, Mac, and Linux. Number 5. BFXR. BFXR is an online tool that excels at generating placeholder sound for your games. It's perfect whenever you're prototyping a pixel art game or participating in a game jam. It is also available as a standalone version for both Windows and Mac. Number 6. Picasa. Picasa is my picture manager of choice. It is clean and easy to use. It integrates with Google Plus, which is a plus, I guess. But it offers one powerful feature that all artists will love. You need to create a reference or mood board for your next painting? With Picasa, you just have to select a few pictures, go to the Create menu and click Picture Collage. Voila. It's Windows only. Number 7. Fast Keys. Fast Keys does a great job at automating tasks. It's a text expander, macro manager, and auto-completion software. You can add shortcuts, set up mouse gestures, create your own context menu. FastKeys offers many, many handy functions. It is very discreet, but it's great to be able to pass text without formatting or to lower your speaker's volume with just your mouse wheel. It is available for free with occasional reminders to buy a license. Otherwise, it only costs 10 bucks. Number 8 is KeePass. You may not have expected a tool like KeePass in that list. KeePass is an account and password manager. It offers a safe way to store all of your online account data in one place. Not only that, but it can type your account credentials on forums and social networks faster than light. You can also open a list of websites from this within the software and categorize your accounts. Let us now take a look at some web-based tools. Number 9 for this list is Trello. Trello offers a visual and flexible way to plan your projects. On Trello, you can organize your team's work with cards and to-do lists. You can upload photos and add colored labels to your cards. It's visual, it's intuitive, and it works with simple drag-and-drop interactions. On top of that, Trello works well in conjunction with Dropbox and Google Drive if you need to share files with your teammates. Number 10. Buffer. Buffer is a tool for social media. It makes it easy to queue up posts on your social network accounts and to share articles or pages you stumble upon online. It offers some analytics on your posts as well. Although the free version is limited as far as what you can do, Buffer covers most of your needs as an indie game designer. It is also very easy to use and available as a Chrome extension. Number 11, Conjure.io. Conjure is pretty amazing. If you need to work with an artist, or if you are an artist, you're going to love it. This tool permits you to share your design, get interactive feedback, and approve or disapprove pieces. It handles versioning and variations of your designs beautifully. In that case, you really have to take a look at it to understand how clean and efficient it is. All I can say is that it's an excellent tool to work with your art teammates and freelance designers. And number 12 is Habit RPG. Last but not least, let's take a quick look at this wonderful online app. Habit RPG is a gamified to-do list. It rewards you for getting your work done, which is quite motivating. It feels very unique and practical thanks to its daily system. Dailies are simply recurring tasks you need to tackle each day. On top of that, you can queue up general tasks that you have to do in order to earn more experience points and rewards. If you're struggling to get work done, Habit RPG can help. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Is there any tool you'd like to add to the list? Please share it with everyone in the comments below. This list is just about useful tools I use on a daily basis, so it can definitely be extended. If you like the video and want to see more, you can subscribe to my channel. And don't hesitate to follow me and message me on social networks. Thank you for watching.